Adding Gridfinity to my project desk was one of the best improvements to my workflow so far. All of the drawers used to be a mess, but with this system, everything finally has its place. However, there's an even more shameful drawer in my studio that needs fixing. And most of the tools in here are so uncommon that I can't just download a ready-made bin for them. So I need to make my own. Luckily, I found an amazing tool somehow nobody talks about that does just that. With a simple photo and a few clicks, it auto-generates Gridfinity boxes, no CAD knowledge required. Let's find out more. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. This video is sponsored by Squarespace. Not everyone knows CAD or has the time to design dozens of custom Gridfinity boxes. So when I was at Open Source this year, a fantastic show for makers and creators, I found the perfect tool to satisfy your OCD, or at least mine. It's called ToolTrace.AI, a free online generator that creates custom shadow board files or even Gridfinity bins, basically with a click of a button. So nobody has an excuse anymore to not use Gridfinity. But how are you currently making your custom Gridfinity bins? Are you designing them yourself? Are you just downloading the ones somebody else already designed? Or if you don't find anything matching, are you just simply throwing these parts into a generic bin? Let me know in the comments. I'd be really curious to know if such an automatic generator helps. So I've got this other drawer of shame. While the drawers on my project desk were just messy, this one is downright embarrassing. Mitutoyo has generously provided me with some of their amazing precision tools over the years, but since I had nowhere to properly store them, they ended up just piled on top of my screwdrivers. All of that is my tool trolley filled with tools of questionable quality, so I thought this is finally the chance to clean up some drawers of things I never use anyways and organize things in there I actually need every day. One of the drawers was already mostly empty, so the first thing that I did was to move the leftover stuff into another drawer, which will be tomorrow's Stefan's problem, and then remove the existing shadow board. So let's put Gridfinity in there. Zach Friedman's organization system basically consists out of a base plate grid and the containers that fit onto it. To make the base plate, I measured the drawer dimensions and plugged them into one of the numerous online generators that I also linked in the description. Since the base plate was too big, I simply cut it up in the slicer with a cutting tool so I can print it piece by piece. Now let's get to the Gridfinity boxes that actually hold the tools. There are a ton of designs for common tools already available on the usual 3D model sites, but if you've got something less common, you'll have to make them yourself. In the past, I usually designed mine in CAD, which works well but takes time. And let's be honest, not everyone wants or can dive into design software. That's where ToolTrace.AI comes in. It's a website that tries to automate the most time-consuming part of making custom tool inserts. Their main business seems to be making machine shadow boards that you can order, but you can also just download the designs and make them yourself. So honestly, I'm not 100% sure what else they do. Most of the links on their site just lead to dead ends. And I'm curious to see if we'll also crash their servers once all of you start generating your Gridfinity bins there. And that's a perfect segue to today's video sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one website builder that lets anyone create a beautiful website without writing a single line of code. I've been using Squarespace myself for years for my own website. It's where I share additional content and guide people to our online store. Building a site on Squarespace is super simple. You can start from one of their beautiful templates and customize that to however you like. Or if you want a head start, you can try their new Blueprint AI tool, which generates a complete website draft for you, sample content included, with just a few questions. With just a click, you can add a fully fledged online store to sell physical or digital products. Creators can host courses or even build communities with memberships. And the best part, you can try all of this completely for free by going to squarespace.com/cnckitchen. When you're ready to launch, use code CNCKitchen to save 10% on your first purchase of a website or a domain. Personally, what's made Squarespace so enjoyable for me to use is not only their intuitive editor, but sometimes even more important, their excellent help center. It's one of the best I've ever seen, and it saved me countless of times when I needed a quick solution. So stop putting it off. Create the website you've always wanted, or finally replace the old one that you've always hated. Check squarespace.com/cnckitchen for a free trial, and don't forget to use code cnckitchen at checkout for 10% off. Thanks again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Using ToolTrace AI is actually really simple. All you need is a photo of your tool with a sheet of paper for a size reference. I laid everything out on the floor and placed the tool on an A4 sheet for a good contrast and took the picture straight from above to reduce distortion. That's it. The paper, by the way, doesn't need to be white, and the tool also doesn't need to be on the paper, but it helps with edge detection. On the website, just hit get started, upload your photo, and a few seconds later, you're in the editor. Just for completeness, this also works on phones or tablets. Well, at least if you're running iOS, though it has been a bit buggy here as well. That's why I did everything on my PC, and I also don't have to transfer the STL to my computer, where I slice. The first step is telling which paper size you use, and then select the sheet on the screen, so it can scale everything correctly. In my case, that was A4, and the software automatically recognized the corners pretty well. To add a new tool, first click New Tool and then hover over it. The software gives you a rough preview of the outline. For simple shapes, that's enough, but if your tool has multiple colors, you'll need to add a few markers so it captures the full shape. Otherwise, the cutout won't fit. Since ToolTrace AI is primarily meant for their shadowboard cutting business, you'll first need to switch the mode from foam to Gridfinity, then change the units to millimeters, since that's what Gridfinity uses. After that, set your pocket depth. The software always generates a 10mm base and adds your chosen depth on top. Because Gridfinity bins use 7mm height units, I went with a 15.4mm pocket depth, giving me the proper 2-unit bin height. The next setting is the offset distance, basically how much space is left between your tool and the cutout wall. The default medium was usually too loose for me, so I had better results using the small setting. Then comes the layout. The generator automatically rotates your part to one of its main axes, but you can always tweak the orientation if you don't like it. In the background, you'll already see the preview of the bin. Here it was a 3x2 grid. A neat option at this stage is adding finger notches, which makes it much easier to pull the tool out of its pocket. And that's practically it. The design is ready, and you can check if everything is right in the 3D preview. If you're happy, you can download it in different formats. I grabbed the STL that I can directly 3D print. One thing I really missed in the Gridfinity setup I made for my project desk was having bins in two colors. What makes traditional shadow boards so appealing is that they are cut from layered foam, usually a bright color, underneath a black top. When you cut out the pockets, you not only get a place to hold the tool, but when it's missing, you also see a clear silhouette. In my small drawers, that wasn't a big deal. But for the larger drawers, that feature would be great. So let's this time make them dual color. Even though Mitutoyo's corporate color is orange, when I think of their tools, I always have a black and yellow theme in my head, which is why I had to use this one here as well. But Mitutoyo yellow isn't a standard bright yellow shade, but it's a bit more pale. I tried finding a matching filament on filamentcolors.xyz with their over 3000 filaments database. It suggested Cookie Cat pale yellow as a match, but since I can't easily get that here in Germany, I ended up browsing Amazon and found a pineapple yellow from Solein that seemed close. When it arrived, the color match was alright, though the filament itself turned out to be a bit questionable, which I'll get into in a minute. So let's prepare the files. When you download a design from ToolTrace AI, you actually get two files. One is the bin and the other one is a 0.5mm insert. If you load them into Bamboo Studio, it asks if it is a multi-body part. When you click yes, the bin and the insert perfectly aligns. With a multicolor printer, you can now assign different filaments, but that means several material changes and takes time whenever both colors print on the same layer. My walkaround was to assign the same filament to both parts and then just add a single manual color change in the G-code preview. That way you still get a nice silhouette effect without needing an AMS, and even a 10-year-old printer can handle that. In hindsight, I overcomplicated it, and the smarter move would have been to print the parts separately in different colors and then just drop the insert into the finished bin. And if it's too tight, you can easily tweak the fit by using a small negative XY compensation in your slicer. I really don't know why I didn't think of that in the beginning, but I ended up printing all of the bins half yellow, half black. Of course, once a project is finished, you're always smarter, and mistakes are part of the learning process. Using the inserts would also have saved me from my problem with the PLA from Soleian, which just wouldn't want to bond with my black PLA I used as a base. On the bigger bins, this turned into a real headache. Layer split apart, I had to reprint several times, and in some cases even glue the pieces back together. But honestly, what did I expect from a 12 euro spool of filament? You might have noticed that I didn't stick to the usual shadow board rule of a black top with a colored insert. I actually tried both versions right at the start and ended up liking the yellow bins way more than the boring black ones. Any objections? I printed the bins on my H2S and most of the prints went smoothly, aside from the layer adhesion issue I mentioned earlier. For the oversized bins, I just cut them into half so they'd fit on the print bed. Some designs ended up with a lot of empty space, and yes, I could have combined tools into fewer bins, but I wanted to keep the modularity. For those bins with extra room, I often used the slicer's add negative part function to create extra pockets for accessories. If you've got multiple tools with the same shape, you can also add a text label directly on the bins. Pretty much all slicers now let you emboss or engrave text, and if you've got a multicolor printer, you can even print the text in a different filament color. Or, of course, just color it in with a Sharpie. Since the bins didn't need to be super strong, I only printed them with 5% infill and a single bottom layer, enough for good bed adhesion without wasting material where it's not needed. And there they are, quite an assortment of Gridfinity bins that I can finally drop into the drawer to satisfy my OCD. I couldn't quite fit everything though. The depth gauge is just too big for this drawer, but since Gridfinity is stackable and I don't need the big caliper every day, I just stack the bins. I'm really happy with the result. At last, all of my expensive measuring equipment now has its own proper place to store it safely, and so I can always directly find what I need. Creating the bins with ToolTrace.AI went really smoothly. I had very few issues with the generator, and it saved me a ton of time. That said, I do have some feature requests. First, it would be great if they would use the Gridfinity standard for the bin height. Second, I'd love a preview of the detected outline right in the tool selection window, so you can double check that everything was captured correctly. Third, it would be super useful to have some basic shape tools in the layout tab, so you could directly add extra cutouts for accessories. And at last, please give me a zoom option in the tool selection window, because depending on my screen resolution, picking things precisely can sometimes be really tricky. Other than that, I think it's an amazing tool for everyone who wants better drawer organization, but doesn't want or can't design bins in CAD. Sure, some outlines are a bit rough, with splines instead of straight edges. But for this application, I think it's totally fine. Pro tip, you can also export the design as a step file and tweak it further in CAD if you want to add details. And ToolTrace, please keep this free for everyone. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you found this video interesting. If you want to support my work, head over to Patreon or become a YouTube member. Also, check out the other videos in my library. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye.